Hi, STEM scholars. I'm Dr. Kelly Christopher, and today I'm really excited to talk to you about density. Density is a scientific term that expresses the relationship between an object's mass and its volume. Mass is similar to weight. On Earth, things that have the same weight will have the same mass, typically. And so an elephant would have a greater mass than a mouse, for example. To explain volume, I've created just a little demonstration just to give you an example. Okay, so we've got a tennis ball and a golf ball here. The tennis ball and golf ball are different sizes. They take up a different amount of space. The tennis ball takes up a greater amount of space than the golf ball. Therefore, the volume of the tennis ball is greater than the volume of the golf ball. So how can we put those two things together, mass and volume? Well, again, I have something to show you that might help. I have two containers. They are both the same volume, meaning they take up the same amount of space. However, I filled one container with brown sugar and I've filled another container with cotton balls. So again, they have the same volume, but they don't necessarily have the same mass. And to prove that, I've got some scales here. I'm just gonna turn them on. Okay. I'm gonna get the mass of the cotton balls and the mass of the brown sugar. We can see that the mass of the cotton balls is 40 grams, where the mass of the brown sugar is 225.5 grams. And so therefore, the density of the brown sugar is greater than the density of the cotton balls, because even though they have the same volume, one has a greater mass, and that relationship is also called density. Now those are solid items, but we're also going to take a moment to look at some items that are liquids. Liquids have different densities. To do this, we're gonna put everything in a column. You might have a cup, a clear cup preferably, that you can use at home. Now the liquids that we are going to measure today are going to be corn syrup, water, dish soap, and vegetable oil. I colored the corn syrup and I colored the water just so that we can see the difference and they don't look all the same, okay? So I'm gonna start with the corn syrup and I'm gonna add that to this cylinder, this cup. Corn syrup is pretty sticky, so I'm intentionally putting it at the bottom. All right. Next, I'm going to add water. Now, when you do this experiment, sometimes it takes a minute for everything to settle down, but you can see that the liquids are separating and the water is less dense than the corn syrup. So the water rises to the top and the corn syrup remains on the bottom. The corn syrup is more dense. Now we're gonna add our dish soap. Okay. We'll take a minute to just make sure that the dish soap settles. But as you can see, the dish soap is more dense than the water, but it's less dense than the corn syrup. So it is between the corn syrup and the water. The water is green. And finally, I'm gonna add some vegetable oil. Again, you might just give it a minute, but you might be familiar with vegetable oil being mixed in salad dressings. There's quite a few bubbles in here. Or if you've washed dishes, you may have noticed that when you have oil and water together, the oil will rise to the top of the dishes. So this is our vegetable oil. That is less dense than the water. And then the dish soap, and then the corn syrup. You can clearly see which one is less dense by the level that it appears in this column. Another thing that this experiment demonstrates is somewhat of another scientific term called buoyancy. Something that is less dense will float on top of something that is more dense. That's how huge cruise ships and ocean liners are able to float on water, because even though they are very, very heavy and have a great mass, they're still less dense than water, so they will float on top of the water. Today's activity that we're going to be doing, we're going to be making a Cartesian diver, and we're going to be using what we know about density and what we know about buoyancy, and a new term, Boyle's Law, that we'll discuss a little bit later. All right, so to make this Cartesian diver, you're just going to need a couple of things. You're going to need a plastic pipette, a hex nut, a marker of some kind. You'll need some water to test it. You're going to have to float this Cartesian diver. You'll need a pair of scissors and a ruler. To make the Cartesian diver, we will be measuring 15 millimeters of the pipette stem. The pipette has a bulb part, which is the part that you squeeze and release to suck up fluids. And then the stem part picks up the liquid. Our rulers have two types of measurements. One side is the English units that has inches on it, but today we're going to be using the metric side, which has centimeters. Millimeters are the tiny little hash marks between the centimeter marks, and there are 10 millimeters in every centimeter. So today we are going to measure 15 millimeters of the stem of the pipette. We're going to start here, and we're going to go to 15 millimeters, which is halfway between the 1 and 2 centimeter marks. We're going to take a marker just to mark that measurement, and then we're going to cut the pipette right there. Okay, so after you have cut your pipette, you're going to take your hex nut and you are going to screw it onto the pipette, and you're going to have to push down a little bit because the hex nut has to create its own thread. And once that is relatively secure, you can go to the next part. This is pretty much all you need, but now you have to sort of calibrate it so that it floats correctly. When you first put the Cartesian diver in the water, it will float pretty easily. But the goal that we're trying to achieve is that we want it to barely float. So we're going to add some water to the Cartesian diver instrument until it is barely floating. I'm going to do that by using this just like I would use a dropper. I'm going to squeeze it, I'm going to put it under the water, and then I'm going to release it so that water is sucked up inside of the Cartesian diver. Now I'm going to try to let it float. Oh wow, that is pretty much exactly how we want it to go. However, you might find that you need to take a few drops of water and let it out so that it floats just right, or you might have to add more water to it so that it floats just right, but we want it to float so that it's just barely floating and the tip of the Cartesian diver just touches the surface of the water. All right, so now what we're gonna do is we're gonna take a 2-liter bottle and fill it with water. Now that we've calibrated our Cartesian diver, we're gonna stick it into the big 2-liter bottle. And then we're gonna secure the top of the bottle by putting the top back on. Now, if this works correctly, when I squeeze the bottle of water, the Cartesian diver should move. All right, you see how I squeezed it? It went down. When I release it, it goes back up. So why is that? Why when I squeeze it, does the Cartesian diver go down? And when I release it, it goes back up. That can be explained with Boyle's Law. The Cartesian diver is partially filled with air particles and partially filled with water particles. When we squeeze the bottle, the pressure inside the bottle increases. Boyle's Law states that when the pressure on a gas is increased, the gas compresses into a smaller volume. Air particles can be compressed, but liquids and solids cannot. So when we squeeze the bottle, the pressure on our Cartesian diver increases. Water enters its opening and the air inside it is compressed. With more water inside, the density of the Cartesian diver increases and it starts to sink. When we release the bottle and the pressure decreases, the air expands back to its original volume and the density of the Cartesian diver decreases and it starts to float again. Now this Cartesian diver is a lot of fun, but it has a lot of small parts, and I was a little concerned that you might have young siblings that might get a hold of that hex nut. So I also got these online. They're a little toy, and they're a Cartesian diver that you can use, and it's slightly more safe than the hex nut. But in order for you to do this one again, you still want to keep it away from very small children. I'm going to just put this little Cartesian diver toy into a bottle of water, and it should work the same way. Put the top back on the bottle, and let's see, I'm going to squeeze it, and the little Cartesian diver toy floats down. I release it, and the Cartesian diver toy floats back up. Well, that's all for today. I hope you learned something, and I hope you had fun. We'll see you next time. Bye-bye.